Sterling Knightlife. I am Sean McAleer, joined by
Mason Hample
and Parker Bell.
Now, a lot of people have been wondering, how is the news film? And as you can see, we are sitting on the news set. Well, luckily today, Parker has footage of behind the scenes of how everything is done. Let's go to that now.
Hello, and welcome to my segment on Knightlife. We are at the Channel 19 TV studio. Well, exactly, like, right in front of it. We're going to go in and see how they film the news.
We're going to do a quick sound check. Mario?
Hi. Life is going pretty well. I took my second testosterone shot yesterday. Life is going well.
John, your turn.
I was Santa Claus for block two.
You saw that?
Who can just stay on by and let the monitors get ready and then we'll turn it off.
We're in the open.
Tell me about the first time you came up here.
The first time I came up here was really scary because I knew no one in this class. So it was scary with all the boards and then the camera on me, but after a while you get really used to it. So like it's just like a normal thing to me at this point.
John, what's it like? What are some things you have to do out here?
You have to like prepare yourself, try to read through the script and see what words might be difficult, ask some questions on how to pronounce some of the names too. And we just have a lot of fun going on here too. We always try to change things up and have new people up here.
How do you keep up with being a director for this TV show?
Well, when you first start being the director of doing the news, it's kind of hard, but once you get used to it, following the scripts for the news is always a good thing, and it's always being a couple steps ahead before something happens.
How do you exactly get those graphics onto the screen that we just saw with Sean?
Well, everything is transmitted wirelessly, and all I have to do is, if I wanted to bring up, say, our reader today, John Howard, just double click it twice and it goes straight to the screen.
How does this exactly work? How do you control it?
Well, the script is usually ready a day before, so all I usually do is I just load it up and then I just run it.
How do you make that stop so people can like read it?
I just click the space bar, or I usually control it with the mouse like this.
How does the soundboard work?
So this controls the master volume.
Okay.
This is at zero. No audio can be picked up.
Yeah, even if these are turned up?
Mm-hmm.
Okay.
So if I turn these up and this up, you will hear the volume from both of these microphones.
Mm-hmm.
These buttons mute it.
Yep.
So no audio can come through. And once we are done, we unmute them.
Bring turn them down.
Back to zero. And
yep. So I'm guessing one is microphone one and two is microphone two. Okay.
Yeah, normally I'll be in charge of that. All I do is click a button and it will show up. As you can see right now, Mr. Farr is making a new one for tomorrow's news.
So I'm guessing it's the same thing as Shrey's job with like clicking it and then it transmits over to the screen.
Just click and it shows up and right behind the reader.
What was the inspiration for starting Nightline News?
Well, we only
had a newscast when I first started here. It was a homeroom newscast that we did live. And then through the years, things changed, schedules changed, and the Nightline thing, actually the name came from a student suggestion, and it just kind of turned into, over the years, as technology changed and the schedule kind of adapted, it turned into what it is now, about a 5-minute newscast every day.
Has there been any significant changes to how the news was produced over the years?
Well, yeah, as technology changed, a lot of stuff had to be adapted. From when I first started here, it was all analog, which meant it was all tapes and VCRs. Now it's all digital and computers. So yeah, through the years, things have changed, but the basic idea is the teachers send me stories that we need to put out, administrators same way, and in fact, some students sometimes have stories they need put out. And they send them to me, and I turn them around and have the students then produce the news on a daily basis. So, in a way, technology changed, but not necessarily the newscast so much.
And is there anything new that you want to add to the newscast in the future?
Well, you never know where the technology is going to go. With the time limitations that we have right now, only a 5-minute, like I said, 5 to 10 at the max, I'm not sure how much more we could do with it. I mean, there's always more creative ways to go about the graphics and always make the reading out a little bit better, maybe some more reporting of stories. But again, it depends on the students and it depends on the technology.
Amazing. Parker, what was the most impressive thing that you saw in the news set?
I would say the technology and how the news is put together so flawlessly.
Wonderful. The other impressive thing with our school is pep rallies. Now, a lot of people have also been wondering, how are these formed and how are all the games made? Well, luckily for you today, our Mason Hample has gotten behind-the-scenes footage and interviews with the people that have created them.
Hello, my name is Mason Hample, and today we are bringing you the Fall 2021 Pep Rally Behind the Scenes. Let's take a look.
How many years you've been doing this? How'd you get involved with this mess?
I don't even know, a long time. and I got involved because it's fun. You know, you get to work with different students. Usually I only teach freshmen, so I get to work with the upperclassmen and, you know, plan things that are meaningful for the school.
What are some things you do to help set up for the pep rally?
We get all of the materials that we need for games set up. Any game that is going to be played, we will set up prior to the pep rally so we can flow easily in the pep rally.
What are some good and bad things for being outside?
Good things, I mean, we're outside, we're getting fresh air, you have like, it's not as loud, so a lot of people won't complain as much with the loudness, because inside it does get a little loud. You know, some negatives, getting everything out there, and just getting the students out there does take a little bit more time.
This was an outdoor pep rally. What are some good games outside?
This time they really did enjoy head, shoulders, knees, and toes. Another one that we didn't play this time around is rock, paper, scissors, shoot. One that didn't work was the balloon game. It didn't take into effect the wind.
When you're planning for this pep rally, about how long, any hour-wise, do you think it took overall with all the stuff you put into it?
I couldn't say hour-wise, because I don't count my hours like that, but you know, there's a lot of things that go into it. The kids have to plan. This time we were trying to hold the teams a little bit more accountable to come up with something. So, you know, getting on some of the teams, like, what are you singing? What are you doing? And, you know, we had another thing planned with, like, finish the lyric that we have to, you know, time out when you're going to, like, cut the song and all of that. So and there's a lot of planning that does go into it. So we do have, for the winter pep rally, finish the lyric since we didn't do it this year. The Spirit Week Pep Rally is always everybody's favorite because it's a battle against the classes. And, you know, we kind of have to let the kids decide what they want to do because, you know, what I want to do is not what a 17-year-old would want to do.
Amazing. Mason, what is one of the most impressive things you found out about our pep rallies?
The students' energy are just unmatched.
Talking about the pep rallies, we have clips on the Channel 19 YouTube channel. And talking about YouTube, we have a YouTube star right in our TV studio, Sean. Sean runs a channel called TNF Stories, and let's see what happens behind the scenes of that.
Sean McAleer, also known as TNF Stories on YouTube. Today I'm going to take you behind the scenes of how my videos are filmed, scripted, and edited. What they are is when you take this little tiny face piece, or any face piece, you take a mixture of silicone putty, which we use very little here due to the fact of how expensive it was. I think it was like 26 for both of it, and it's only small amounts. And the way how you do is you take both colors, and what happens when you use both is you take a little bit of blue and a little bit of white, mix it together, and rub it around for a couple of minutes. And after you get it to a nice firm state, you press the faceplate in and you wait for about an hour for it to cast. Now that we're back with some paper plates, I'm going to show you guys what paint mixing is. Now, for those who do not know what paint mixing is, which Ms. Phillips has taught me when I was in our class, is you take two colors, such as this gloss real brown and a apple barrel white, which I'll give both camera shots. I'm going to take a little bit of brown, which hopefully I don't put too much in this. Like that. Go off here. Then you take a little bit of white that I have here. Go. Now, the biggest problem is with this white, for some odd reason. This white is not even like a liquid, it is like a paste. And the reason why I say that is because it takes a while for it to get on. Now, for those who are wondering what some paint mixing looks like that I have made, would be my number five engine, James. His paint was paint mixed it all the way. It was a mix of bright red and white, which made it that like gloss looking color, which I love. And also the number one engine, which is over on the other side of the table, is also a paint design that I made on its own, which, you know, it's really hard to make sometimes, but it's also my favorite. Now, people were wondering, like, oh, why did you paint them? Because I didn't like the plastic look to it. It doesn't make it look like it's plastic anymore. It makes it look like it's real. Now we've got trucks. Now we've got something to work with. Now what we're going to do is we're going to do the same thing we did before. Got a blob of black and brown together. Now, that's all painted in a nice new brown.
This used to be a motorized engine. If I remove the body shell, which I won't probably be able to do, this is the key tool to moving things. It's a string that is pulled along by me to help move the engine. Now, as you can see, this was not the original paint. This is all created by me for my feel. This is his faceplate, which will go on during other videos. However, this video is being filmed for a project. A lot more to see on the channel. If you'd like to see what I have more of, please go to subscribe to TNF Stories. I'll be waiting for you there. This is TNF Stories, also Sean signing off, and back to Parker and Mason in the studio.
Well, that was epic. I have a question that wasn't exactly addressed in the video. How long does it take to produce an episode of your TV show?
It could take about a week to a month due to the fact of not having free time or because of my computer not working correctly. Well, that's going to do it this time for Strong Nightlife. I'm Sean McAleer.
I'm Mason Hample.
And I'm Parker Bell.
Have a great new year, and as always,
go Knights!
Three, two, one. Amazing. Sure. That's fine.
Cool. You can do anything you want. Yep.
Now, as you can all see, we are sitting on the night light, or the night time.
Alright, we'll do that.
Just been growing and growing higher.
Yeah, I already added it.
And it's just a great thing to see.
Press a button, look at me. Oh, I didn't want it to get black though.
Mikayla!
You're a jerk.
It's gonna be a white Christmas.
What happened? It's cracked through the bottom, watch out.
Three. Up, people.
So I went fishing and I got this big fish and I tried to haul them in. Don't look at me as you, everybody else is doing the thing. And now I'm coming over here and I'm going like that, and that's what you do. You go like that. You go like this, and I still have no idea what I'm doing.
What? You're not gonna miss it, right?
Three, two, one.
Be safe.
and have a happy new year. Oh god, I messed up. I find awesome.
Happy New Year and go Knights!
Well,
have a good New Year's and go Knights.
You didn't let me draw a card.
3, 2, 1, jump! One, two, three, jump! Oh, we lost somebody. You alright? One, two, three, jump! Oh, we're a little behind with Mason.